हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम एस के निगम, पी जी टी केमिस्ट्री केंद्रीय विद्यालय. नाउ इन दिस सेशन आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द एक्सरसाइज क्वेश्चन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 1, द सॉलिड स्टेट. होप यू विल एंजॉय दिस सेशन. सो कम टू द एक्सरसाइज पोर्शन. नाउ फर्स्ट माई फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन is 1.1, that is define the term amorphous, give a few example of amorphous solid. Amorphous is actually, it is a Greek word, and amorphous means no form, which has no form. So amorphous solids are those solids in which there is not a proper manner of arrangement of the constant particles. That's why it is said that it is having short range order, and the basic example is glass, okay, quartz glass and all the polymers. Now, what makes a glass different from a solid such as quartz? Under what condition could quartz be converted into glass? So glass is amorphous and quartz is a crystalline solid. So in the case of glass, there is no proper or ordered arrangement, whereas in the case of quartz, it has ordered arrangement, and all the differences between crystalline and the amorphous solid, they will show them. Under what condition could quartz be converted into glass? So if quartz is a kind of crystalline solid and you want to convert it into glass, means amorphous solid, then it is very easy process. Just increase the temperature of quartz and just try to melt it, and as you just decrease the temperature of quartz, means you are going to solidify this quartz. If you cool it suddenly, means suddenly if you just lower the temperature of this molten quartz, it will convert into glass. Okay, because random arrangement will be there, means it not become will not be as the crystalline solid, become amorphous solid. The next one is 1.3, classify each of the following solid as ionic, metallic, molecular network or amorphous solid. So it is very clear, tetra phosphorus deca oxide is a kind of molecule, that's why it is a molecular solid. Ammonium phosphate is a kind of ionic solid, that's why it is ionic solid, that is why it is ionic solid. Silicon carbide is a covalent compound, that's why it is covalent solid. Iodine is a kind of molecule, non-polar molecule, that's why it is non-polar molecular solid. P4 is also a non-polar molecular solid. Plastic is a kind of amorphous solid. Then graphite, it is a kind of covalent or the network solid. Brass is a kind of metallic solid. Rubidium is a kind of metal, that's why metallic solid. Lithium bromide is a kind of ionic compound, that's why ionic solid. Then silicon is a kind of metalloid, and that is why silicon is a kind of covalent or network solid. Next one is question number 1.4. What is meant by the term coordination number? The coordination number is the total number of nearest or neighboring atoms which are in direct contact with a particular sphere or a particular constant particle. What is the coordination number of atoms in a cubic close packed structure? It is 12, and in the case of body centered cubic structure, it is 8. So in the case of cubic close packed structure, whenever you have studied about the cubic close packing, so this is the cubic close packing, and in this cubic close packing, the coordination number is 12, which is actually it is 3D structure. It is not very much clear in the 2D structure. Okay, so it is clearly mentioned here that coordination number in case of SCP or CCP, in both the cases, hexagonal close packing as well as the cubic close packing, it is 12 in number. Then body-centered cubic unit cell. So if body-centered unit cell, in the case of body-centered unit cell, so this is the example. This is the sphere which is present at the center of the body. So the coordination number of this particular constant particle is 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So the answer is 8, because 8 spheres or 8 constant particles are in direct contact with the particular body-centered constant particle. Okay. Now, how can you determine the atomic mass of an unknown metal if you know its density and the dimension of its unit cell? Explain. So with the help of this formula only, you can calculate. Density is equal to Z into M upon AQ into NA. So this is the answer. D is equal to ZM, where D is the density, Z is that number of atoms in a particular unit cell, M is the molar mass, A is the edge length, A cube is there, N is the Avogadro number. Now next is the stability of a crystal is reflected in the magnitude of its melting point comment. So the question is, the stability of a crystal is reflected in the magnitude of its melting point. Very clear, If the melting point of a solid or any compound is very high, it represents that the compound is very much stable because the intermolecular force of attraction is very, very high. Clear? Now collect melting point of solid water, ethyl alcohol, ethyl diethyl ether and methane from a data book. What can you say about the intermolecular forces between these molecules? So I have written the melting point of water, it is 273 Kelvin. Ethyl alcohol, it is 155.8 Kelvin. Diethyl ether is having 156.8 Kelvin and methane is having 90.5 Kelvin. So with the help of all these values, it is very clear. So water is having the highest melting point. It means that the intermolecular force of attraction in the case of water in all these four is very high. Clear? So that's why it is having the high melting point. And in the case of methane, it has the least melting point. It represents the intramolecular force of attraction in the molecules, in between the molecules of the methane is very, very low. Clear? Now next one is 1.7. How will you distinguish between the following pairs of terms, hexagonal close packing and cubic close packing? How will you distinguish between? So basic difference is, in the case of hexagonal close packing, the arrangement is ABAB type of layer, and in the case of cubic close packing, it is ABCABC type of packing, which is mentioned here, ABAB and ABCABC type, cubic close and hexagonal. How this ABAB and ABCABC is there? With the help of this diagram, you can very clearly observe this dark color circles are of first layer, it is A, and the dotted circle is the layer B, which is covering the tetrahedral void. Okay, so here T, A or O both are mentioned here. T is for tetrahedral void, O is for octahedral void. If you are placing the third layer, and if you are placing third layer, and third layer is again covering the tetrahedral void, if the third layer is placing over the tetrahedral void, then what is happening? This layer means the third layer is just similar to the first layer. That is why actually it was mentioned in my first video, in which I have clearly shown that how the ABAB is arrangement in the case of SCP and how there is the ABCABC arrangement in the case of cubic close packing. So if third layer is placed and it is covering the tetrahedral void, then it is forming ABAB type of packing, means that is the hexagonal close packing. And if you are covering the octahedral void, means third layer is covering the octahedral void, then it is again the third layer, which is not similar to any one of first and second, so it becomes C layer. Okay, so then it is ABCABC type of layer. So in the case of cubic close packing, ABCABC is there because third layer is not similar to any of these two. And in the case of hexagonal, the third layer is similar to first layer. Clear? How is it possible? When you are covering the tetrahedral void, it become A. And when you are covering the octahedral void, it become C layer. Clear? So this is the difference. Now next is crystal lattice and unit cell. Crystal lattice is the three-dimensional arrangement of all the constituent particles present in a solid, and unit cell is the repeating unit of the any crystal lattice. It is also mentioned in the book as well as in my video. Now next is tetrahedral void and octahedral void. So tetrahedral voids, in the case of tetrahedral void, the coordination number of void is 4, and in the case of octahedral void, the coordination number of void is 6. Okay. And the shape become tetrahedral and the shape become octahedral, as the name indicates. Now next one is, how many lattice points are there in one unit cell of each of the following lattices? So in the case of face-centered cubic unit cell, all the corners are occupied by the particles and every corner is shared by 8 different unit cells. Therefore, the number of atoms shared by the unit cell is equal to 8 into 1 by 8 means 1. So the one particle from the corners, and there are 6 faces, and all the faces are having one sphere at the center, and every face is shared by 2 unit cells. Therefore, the fraction of particle shared by 1 unit cell is 1 upon 2. That is why it is equal to 3. So 3 plus 1 is equal to 4. So the total number of particle in the case of face center unit cell is 4. And it is just similar to face center tetragonal unit cell. It is also having 4. The calculation will be remain same. Only the structure is different from the cubic unit cell. Now next one is body-centered unit cell. So corners are again occupied. Therefore, one portion is from the corners, and at the center of the body one particle is there which is not shared by any other unit cell. It is shared by the particular unit cell in which this particle is present. So the total number of particle 1 plus 1 means 2. So the answer is 2. Now explain the basis of similarities and differences between metallic and ionic crystals. So what are the similarities and what are the differences? So the similarity is, in the case of metals as well as ionic solid or crystals, the intramolecular force of attraction is the kind of Coulombic or electrostatic force of attraction. So the force of attraction is similar in the both the cases. As well as the second similarity is, their bond present between metallic and the ionic solid is non-directional. The bond is non-directional. Clear? And the differences? The differences is, ionic solid involves the ions which are not free in the case of solid state. That is why it is not the conductor in the solid state. It is the conductor in the case of molten state or in its aqueous state. Whereas in the case of metals, it is conductor because of the free electrons. So there is no any kind of bondation, whether it is in solid state or it is in molten state, it will conduct electricity. Clear? Now next one is, ionic solids are hard and brittle. Clear? Ionic solids are hard and brittle because, again, the force of attraction is the electrostatic force of attraction, which is very strong interaction. That's why they are very hard and brittle also, because if you are just going through the structure, for example, plus minus plus, this is the arrangement of the you can say the constant particle in the case of ionic solid. And if you are applying force on the topmost layer of the ionic solid, if it displaces from its own position, so what will happen? The positive sign come over the positive sign and negative sign come over the negative sign. It means they will repel each other, and when they repel each other, they become brittle in nature. So this is the reason of the brittle nature. Next, calculate the efficiency of packing in the case of metal crystal of the simple cubic body center, face center. All these discussions are in the book, and we have discussed in my earlier video, so there is no need to waste our time here. Now next question, 1.11, silver crystallizes in FCC lattice. If S length of the cell is this 4.07 in 10 power 8 minus 8 centimeter and density is 10.5 gram per cubic centimeter, calculate the atomic mass of the silver. So the question is not very difficult. Again, the same formula you have to apply. The formula you have to apply is the formula of density. The formula of density, one question number 1.11. The density is equal to Z m upon a cube n a. All the values are given here. In the case of silver, the FCC means Z is equal to 4, and you have to calculate the molar mass. Density is again given, it is 10.5 gram per cubic centimeter. Sorry, it is not density, it is the here you have to place edge length. It is 4.07 into 10 to the power minus 8 centimeter cube, because the edge length is a centimeter, and in density again cubic centimeter is there. Therefore you need not to change the unit, you have to just directly place the value. And again, the Avogadro number, density is given, which is equal to 10.5. Just solve it for m and you will get the answer. So when you will solve it for the m, the mass become 107.12 gram per mole. This is the answer after calculating all the values, or you will after shifting the values to the other side and solving it. The next one is question 1.12. A cubic solid is made of two elements P and Q. Atom of Q are at the corner of the cube and P at the body center. What is the formula of the compound? What are the condition number of P and Q? So the question is very simple. It is saying that Q at the corner. So how many corners? 8 corners, and every corners are shared by 8 corners, and every corners are shared by 8 different cubes. Therefore the number of Q atom is 1, and P at the center. So at the center means it is not shared by any other. So the ratio of P and Q is 1:1. Therefore formula is PQ, and the coordination number in the case of cubic unit cell, a body centered cubic unit cell, here P is there and Q is placed here. So P is surrounded by 8 Q, means the coordination number of P is 8 as well as condition number Q is also 8, 1, 2, 3, and the cube beside here and in front here and above this. So if you will count it 3D in 3D, then the number of condition number in the case of Q is also 8. Okay. Now next one is 1.1. So niobium crystallizes in body centered cubic structure means Z is equal to 2. If density is 8.55 gram per cubic centimeter, calculate atomic radius of niobium using its atomic mass 93 unified mass. Everything is given here. You have to only apply D, the formula of D, and calculate atomic radius. So in the case in this case, if you are applying the formula of D, that is Zm upon A cube Na, you will get A is the S length. Okay, but you have to calculate here the atomic radius of the niobium. So it is body centered unit cell. Body centered unit cell means there is a relation between R and A in the case of body centered unit cell, and it is R is equal to under root 3 by 4 A. This is the relation of R and A in the case of BCC. So when you will get A from this equation, just place this value of A into this equation and you will get the value of R, which after calculating you will get it R is equal to 0.143 nanometer. This is the answer. I'm not wasting the time in just putting all the values and solving it. Okay, now next one is, if the radius of the octahedral void is small r and the radius of the atom in closed packing is capital R, derive the relation between a small r and the capital R. So in this question, the question number 14, 1.14, first of all you have to draw the diagram. For example, this is the constituent sphere, all these four constituent spheres which are having the capital R radius, and this is the void, octahedral void. So just join the center, and it will form right angle triangle where these are capital R and these places are small r, and this it is A, B and C. It is a right angle triangle, therefore BC square means this is the hypotenuse, it is equal to AC square plus AB square, and BC is equal to a square root of AC means AC means AC square R plus R square plus R plus R square, means it is under root 2 R plus R. After solving it you will get under root 2 R plus R. So what is BC? BC is R plus R, capital R plus capital R means it is capital, it is 2 capital R. Clear? This 2 capital R, and when you will you solve it, it is 2 times of R capital R plus R, that is under root 2, under root 2, then R plus R. Clear? Any confusion? Okay, then after just open it, or you cannot simplify with other method, whatever you want. So after solving it, it become small r is equal to 0.414 capital R. This is the relationship after solving all this. Clear? It is not very difficult. You can solve it by any means, or for example multiply both the side with under root 2, therefore it become 2 cancel out. Okay, let me do it. Okay, just multiply both the side by square root 2, so it become 2 r plus r, so 2 cancel out. Okay, so it is under root 2 r is equal to r plus r, and small r is equal to under root 2 r minus r. Clear? So r is common, under root 2 minus 1 capital R, and the value of under root 2 is 1.414 minus 1 r. After solving it, it is, so this is the relation between small r and capital R. It is not very difficult, it is quite easy. Okay, so this is question number 1.14, and after this question, question number 1.15. copper crystallizes into a face-centered lattice with edge length 3.61 in 10 power minus 8 centimeter. Show that the calculated density is in agreement with its measured value of 8.92 gram per cubic centimeter. So in this question, it is asking that if just you calculate the density of the copper with this formula, and after calculating it, whether it is equal to, it is coming to just this value or not. So for that, you have to use the value of mass of the molar mass of the copper, that is 63.5. So put all the values. Z is 4 because it is FCC. M is 63.5. A is 3.61 in 10 power minus 8 centimeter to the power 3. And Na is the Avogadro numbers, that is 6.022 in 10 power 23. After solving it, you will get 8.92 gram per cubic centimeter is the answer. It means it is clear. Now next one is 1.16. Analysis shows that nickel oxide has the formula Ni 0.9801.00, means it is a kind of non-stoichiometric solid. What fractions of nickel exist as Ni2 plus and Ni3 plus ion? It is also very easy, because in the question 1.16, the formula is Ni 0.9801.00, and the question is asking about the percentage of Ni2 plus and Ni3 plus. Okay, so let the number of Ni2 plus ion is X, therefore the number of Ni3 plus will be 0.98 minus X. Why it is 0.98 minus X? Because it is written in the formula. Okay, because it is a kind of ionic compound and it is neutral compound, therefore the charge possessed by all the ions here collectively, it becomes zero. It means if Ni2 plus is having plus 2 charge and the number of Ni2 plus is X, plus number of charge possessed by Ni3 plus is 3 and the number is 0.98 minus X, as well as plus number of charge possessed by oxide ion is minus 2 and the number of particle, means number of oxide ion, is 1. So it is equal to 0 because it is neutral molecule. So it is 2x plus, multiply it, 2.94 minus 3x minus 2 is equal to 0. Then 2x minus 3x is equal to minus x, and after subtracting 2 from 2.94 is equal to 0.94 is equal to 0. Then X is equal to 0.94. okay, so this is Ni2 plus 0.94. therefore, how many number of Ni3 plus ions? It is 0.98 minus 0.94, means 0.04. so the percentage of Ni2 plus is equal to 0.94 upon 0.98 into 100, which is equal to 96%. Similarly, percentage of Ni3 plus is equal to 0.04 upon 0.98. why this 0.98 is here? Because it is the total number of particles, total number of nickel, and this is the number of Ni2 plus ion, and this is the number of Ni3 plus ion. Just multiplied by 100, it is 4%. So this is the answer: 96% Ni2 plus and 4% Ni3 plus. Okay, now next is 1.17. what is a semiconductor? Semiconductor are a kind of solid whose conductivity lies between conductors and the insulators. The conductivity range is given in the book. They are of two type. They describe the two main types of semiconductor and contrast their conduction mechanism. There are two type of the semiconductor: p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor. In the p-type semiconductor, positive holes are the carrier. In the n-type semiconductor, negative electrons are the carriers. P-type conductors are formed by the doping of intrinsic semiconductor with the 13 group element as impurity, and n-type semiconductors are produced by doping the intrinsic semiconductor with the 15 group element as impurity. So all this is all about the semiconductor. Now next, 18th question. Non-stoichiometric cuprous oxide CuO2 can be prepared in laboratory. In this oxide, copper to oxygen ratio is slightly less than 2:1. Can you account for the fact that this substance is a p-type semiconductor? Very clear. The actual ratio is 2:1, but it is lesser than 2 is to 1, means the number of copper ion is not exactly 2 with respect to the 1. It means the number of copper ions are less. Why number of copper ions are less? Because copper can show variable valency, means in this compound Cu is present as Cu plus, but it has tendency to convert into Cu2 plus, means some of Cu plus ion converted into Cu2 plus, and electronically it is having plus 2 charge. It means if Cu2 plus is there, it will displace 2 Cu plus ion. So if 1 Cu2 plus is there, it will displace 2 Cu plus ion. And if 2 Cu plus ions are displaced, so out of 2, one position is occupied by the Cu2 plus ion, and another become the vacant, means it become the holes. And if it becomes a hole, that's why it become the p-type semiconductor. So next, clear? So it is the explanation of this question. Now the next question is the 19th question. In 19th question, ferric oxide crystallizes in a hexagonal close packed array of oxide ions with 2 out of every 3 octahedral holes occupied by ferric ions. Derive the formula of ferric oxide. So let consider O2 minus means oxide ion is equal to X. Therefore the octahedral void is also equal to X because it is equal to the number of particles present in the crystal. And as the question is asking that out of every three octahedral holes, 2 are occupied by the ferric ions. So 2 by 3 of X. So the ratio between Fe3 plus and O2 minus is equal to 2X by 3 is to 1. XX cancel out, means it is 2 is to 3, and the formula becomes Fe2O3. So it is very easy. So the derivation of the formula is very much easy. It is not very difficult. Now next one is question 1.20. Classify each of the following as being either a P-type or a N-type semiconductor. Germanium doped with indium. So germanium is 14 group element and indium is a 13 group element. So if you are just doping germanium with the 13 group element as impurity, it will form p-type semiconductor. Similarly, in the case of silicon doped with boron, silicon is also 14 group element and boron is a kind of 13 group element. Again, it is having a less number of electron than the silicon, therefore it is p-type semiconductor because the positive holes become the carrier in both the cases. Okay, so I'm moving to the next question. It is 1.21. In this question, gold crystallizes in a face-centered unit cell. What is the length of a side of the cell? Means radius is given here. It is told in the question that is FCC arrangement. Therefore, the arrangement means there is a relation between A and R. R is equal to A upon 2 root 2. And with the help of all these values, you have to calculate the edge length, which is after placing the value of R, you will get the answer. It is 0.407 nanometer. In terms of band theory, what is the difference between conductor and an insulator? So conductor, with the help of band theory, it is in the diagram here. In the case of conductor, they can conduct electricity because in the case of metals or the conductors, the conduction band, valence band, either there is no difference in the energy level, or you can say there is the partial overlapping of the conduction band and the valence band. Means electrons get very easily shipped to the conduction band and they conduct electricity. Whereas in the case of insulator, what is happening? There is a very large forbidden energy gap, and this energy gap cannot be just fulfilled by the electron when you are passing the current through the insulator. The electron cannot jump from the valence band to the conduction band. Now the next one is, between a conductor and a semiconductor. So conductor and semiconductor, the reason will be same, and in the case of semiconductor, there is a difference of the energy between valence band and the conduction band, but this energy gap is not very large, and it can be get by the electron when you are passing electric current through the system. Next question, 1.23. Explain the following terms with suitable examples. Schottky defect, Frankel defect, interstitial and F-center, all are discussed in my earlier videos. Schottky defects, in this case it is a kind of vacancy defect in the ionic solid. Equal number of cations and anions are missing and the density get decreases. In the case of Frankel defect, it is termed as dislocation defect because the cations just leave their position and occupy the interstitial spaces. The density remains same in the case of Frankel defect. In the case of Schottky defect, the size of the cations and anions are considerably same, and in the case of Frenkel defect, there is a greater size difference between cations and the anions. Interstitial defects are generally caused in the case of non-ionic solid, in which along with the original position of the constant particles, some constant particles are located in the interstitial sites, and due to this, the density of the interstitial defects, in the case of interstitial defect, the density increases. F-centers, it is caused when there is a non-stoichiometric defect, and it is a kind of metal excess defect due to anionic vacancy, in which there is the anionic vacancy, and this anionic vacancy is fulfilled by the electron, and this electron become the color center of that particular solid. That's why it is termed as F-center or Fabian-Jenter center. Now next is the aluminium crystal. Question number 1.24. Aluminium crystallizes in a cubic close packed structure. Cubic close packed structure means it is also similar to SCP or FCC. FCC means face centered cubic unit cell. Its metallic radius is given 1.125 picometer. You have to convert it into centimeter or meter. What is the length of the side of the unit cell? So if it is cubic close packed structure or FCC arrangement, so the relation between R and A, R is the radius and A is the edge length, is given written here, A upon 2 root 2. So with the help of this formula, you can calculate the side of the unit cell, means A can be calculated. And the next part is how many unit cells are there in 1.00 cubic centimeter of aluminium. So with the help of A, which you have calculated here, 3.5 picometer, you can calculate the volume of one unit cell. With the volume of one unit cell, and if you want to calculate the number of unit cell in 1 cubic centimeter aluminium, so that number of unit cell is equal to 1 upon a cube. With the help of this, 1 is the given volume and a cube is the volume of one unit cell. With the help of this formula, you can calculate the value of number of unit cell present. Now next one, 1.25. If NaCl is doped with 10⁻³ mole percent of SrCl2, what is the concentration of cationic vacancy? So as discussed earlier many times, that strontium chloride, every Sr2+ ion is creating one cationic vacancy. So first of all, it is given in the percentage. So you have to convert it into the number of moles. 10⁻³ mole percent of SrCl2 means it is divided by 100 to convert it into the number of moles. It is 10⁻⁵ moles. So the total number of Sr2+ ions are 10⁻⁵ mole. And if every Sr2+ is creating one cationic vacancy, therefore 10⁻⁵ mole Sr2+ are creating 10⁻⁵ mole cationic vacancies. So mole, the value of mole placed here, and just after solving it, the answer is 6.022 into 10⁻¹⁸ cationic vacancy. So this is the answer. 6.022 into 10⁻¹⁸ cationic vacancies are there. Now next, last question, 1.26. Explain the following with a suitable example. Ferromagnetism, paramagnetism, ferrimagnetism, antiferro, and 12-16 and 13-15 group compounds. Out of all these five, generally one short note is asking in the board examination. Ferromagnetism. Ferromagnetism is a kind of property in which the substances are strongly attracted towards the external magnetic field, because the domains are aligned themselves in a same alignment, like in this diagram. This is the diagram of ferromagnetic substances, and after just cutting the external source of magnetic field, they remain aligned in the particular direction. That's why they form the permanent magnet. Paramagnetism. They are weakly attracted towards the external magnetic field. And why they are weakly attracted? Because they have the electrons, unpaired electrons, and every unpaired electron is having some magnetic moment, and this because of this magnetic moment, they attract towards the external magnetic field. Next is ferrimagnetism. Ferrimagnetism is also a kind of property in which they are weakly attracted towards the external magnetic field, because the number of domains are the parallel and anti-parallel arrangement in this ferrimagnetic substances are not equal in number. They are unequal in number. That is why they have weak magnetic field, they have weak magnetic moment, and they are weakly attracted towards the external magnetic field. Antiferromagnetism, they are strongly repelled by the external magnetic field, because the parallel and anti-parallel arrangement are equal in number. So the parallel, the domains which are arranged parallel, the magnetic moment of these domains are cancelled by the magnetic moment of anti-parallel domains. So they are strongly repelled. Next is 12, 16 and 13, 15 group of compound. Basically, these are the alternatives of the semiconductors. In 12, 16, one member of 12th group and one member of 16 group are mixing together to form a semiconductor. And in the case of 13, 15 compound, one member of 13 group and one member of 15 group element combine to form a compound. And these two compounds are very good. They can show the semiconductivity. This is all about the exercise questions of chapter number 1. Okay, so if you like this video, kindly like, subscribe and share. Thank you.